about the project was, this is Serpy. Now today I'm going to talk about a video that took place in the real Hollywood, you know, St. James, not that made up stuff we're going in America. St. James, Jamaica is the real Hollywood, right? This video, I'm just going to be honest, and this might be a bold statement. Of all them video I've seen from you on this platform, this one might be the most troubling. Not because there's anything like where it's so, you know, it's so extreme that I can't sleep at night because I'm sick, but because while I was watching the video, I realized there was somebody in the video. Somebody who, you know what, before I go into that, let me give you the backstory. Yesterday, when I did the video about the artist who lose him life, right? The one that come from Mount Salem, right? Use the name, quote unquote, Father God. In that video, I said, well, you know, maybe a man named Tinga already. Right? So there's very likely to be retaliation. And, you know, Mount Salem is always hot. Even it appears there maybe a quiet things are going. But what happened to that artist just might trigger off some foolishness. Well, the foolishness reach less than 24 hours. You see, the same place where the artist losing life, over Peace View, right? Some man circle back in what appears to be retaliation for him to the artist. And the video is, I'm not going to do a shit, man. I don't even know where to start. You see, I'm doing two videos today. There's going to be this video that you're listening to now on the, you know, your mainstream YouTube platform, and the second video is going to be on Patreon. Link is in the description. I'm going to break that video down. I'm going to show you how 87s in Jamaica operate. I'm going to show you why I'm telling you, say, your favorite 87. Their ops are so cartoonish, are so risky, right? That's when you see videos like this, you understand why innocent people get caught tonight all the time. It was a complete circus. Right? Now in the video, right? You see like a shop, right? There's somebody's camera pointing down upon the road, and the vehicle them dead and, you know, them take time pull up. And then out of nowhere, you see some car pull up and the man then jump out. Run going to my shop. But there was a man in the shop who had turned up earlier. He turned up earlier with somebody who, well, that's why I said this is probably one of the most troubling videos I ever see. That man had turned up with a little pitney. Right? He was holding her hand. They weren't going to the shop. The 87 of them run out and run going at the shop. And some of them start to engage this man immediately drop. Another said, start fire for some people who they close by because somebody spot them and them jump out of the car and start run off. Like you can see up at the top of the video. Right? It's like people start fire for a shop because I heard it's actually about 3 people will not get hit. Right? And next said, start focus on down the road. One of them run gone down the road. While this are gone, the little girl is in the middle of everything. People at Jamaica want to have to see this video. Let me say, Patreon, we're going to break it down for them. Break it down myself, because I'm not worried about nothing in that video. Because 2021, I'm charged. So I can't believe what I just see. You see, I want thing to read about it in the papers. And hear say them things that go on, but when you see on video with your own 2 eyes, the little pitney in the middle of everything, the little pitney in the shop when the man them go in there, the little pitney run go down the road. I don't even know if it's that. The little girl run go down the road, she's so confused, she turn back and run go back into the shop. Even while she run down the hill, 87 them are fire down the hill, same direction as the pitney, you can see the roads in my lick on the ground. That child is covered. The fox say, none of the rounds them no catch. That child, tell me said that child have some special calling in her life. That look, that child go grow up come be some. Because that child clearly affy live for grow up come be some. Because in the video, all me are wait to see. Is the pitney drop. Because based on where them are fire and where the pitney there, you're thinking to yourself, see, you know? And you start brace yourself. Well, I was bracing myself for what me think that will happen. Somehow. I'm telling you, say that pitney is covered, that pitney is going to grow up to become a star among stars. In whatever field she grow up come do, she have to excel. Because fear destiny is clearly written amongst the stars. Because I don't know how the people are still there today. But even though the child never get hurt, physically, think about the mental side of where that look a bit me, just witness. Most adults couldn't stomach what we just seen in the video. If most adults, big people, they stand up, in the middle of Ireland, they couldn't stomach. They couldn't sleep for weeks. They couldn't eat properly. And I look at Pitney just to get up on it, man. Jamaican Pitney, a lot of them, come from these acidic places, need therapy. Need counseling, because some things them see. Only soldiers and police will only experience them things in them real life on a regular basis. Jamaican Pitney need counseling. But you see, these videos have to come out. I'm glad the video come out because the people in Jamaica need to see where them love support. The people in Jamaica need to see the real face of the country. The people need to see the real mother in Jamaica. The world need to see Jamaica. And what we have become. That's the real Jamaica right there. That's not made up. Fairy tale, Irish man, foolishness. That's the real Jamaica right there, son. That's the Jamaica where society has built. And that's the society, we're going to leave behind for our children. Acidity, death, and destruction. I'm glad the video come out. No one can see. We want to love. That's what you love, right? This is what you support, right? 87 them in them video day. If any of them drop tomorrow morning, you're gonna hear the sad story from them kerosene and them mother and them auntie and them neighbor. They're gonna say father, because most of them are not father. And you're gonna hear say, why them have to do him like that? He's been through so much. Well, I'm glad to see what input other people through. I'm glad to see what input. A little bit in there too. I don't know what relationship is between the little girl and the man they're dropping at the shop. Could be her father, I don't know, could be her uncle. Right in front of her. That's the real Jamaica. I'm glad the video come out. I'm glad the video come out. I'm not glad I'm seeing the video, but I'm glad it come out. Because this video say 10,000 words. I'm saying picture say 1,000 words, but that video say 10,000. Suppose they still hit them there. Me no know how them hit each other with them own around. The man them wild and fool. So just like the last video. The one where they go on down, I think it now would. Your favorite 87 is a joke. Your favorite 87 is a clown. Circus ops. The reason why them can't build so much reputation and run out of places because they're armed and the people are not. This is why no matter how much you tell me about your favorite 87 will lock off much ends and 15, 20 bodies. I don't care, I don't respect your favorite 87. I don't. Because this is how most of them make them name them, run on pan people like this. And then do things like this and then go back pan them car and go brag. The man them look like a complete circus. I've never seen, well, not never, let me take that back. to be honest, most of these videos are the same. 87 just wild and other BFOs, but I've never seen the part that really get to me is the fact, say, Eve went in the morning, she say, the little bit near run down the hill. She might as well be invisible. She might as well be invisible. At one point, one of the man them jump out with a rifle, and even though the man they're on the ground already, but just through most of the people them running on anymore and say him do something, him still going to the shop, go add on theme unnecessary. Theme unnecessary rounds them, because him need for bribe when he go back, say, yeah man, I'm going to do this to you now. That's your favorite 87. That's your heroes, that's your idols. That's who you look up to, that's who you want to be. This video did have to come out, and more videos like it have to come out, so the people them can see the real Jamaica. And maybe then, some of the woke TV some would have gone like, who come on your social media pages all day come ball, right, and tell you what 87s have been through, and why them have to do, no one see why some of them get to them get. And you know what's the worst thing? Not even the presence of the little girl already there. That is not enough to trigger the maternal instincts within certain kerosene to say, you know what, they know when you're a man like this, who would do something like that. A matter of fact, if anything, it made them even more attracted to them 87. Boy, him cold, man. Him cold. All the time, all the pit in the day, not even stop him. Him cold. The mothers of these youths who support them, full of material instincts not kick in. When you see them video, probably not. I found it even a bit them anyway. See, when they meet a dropout, but your story say, oh, they did the best they could and get in good parenting and good parenting. We could talk about good parenting in Jamaica. No? What Jamaican parents are do differently now than what Jamaican parents used to do? If modern day Jamaican parents are so amazing, why are they not delivering the results? Because the results are the youths we are produced. If old time Jamaicans did have it wrong, why were they getting better results? Come on, hit the dislike button, woke divis, modern day woke divis. If old time Jamaicans, who were told were backward and illiterate and duns, right, and never knew what they do, and now we're all enlightened and living in this amazing, amazing day and age, since they had it wrong, why they never produce so much 87s? Why that culture never produce 87? Like how Toyota produce car. Well, talk to me, walk to this. I'm listening. Tell me in the comment section. Enlighten me. Because, you know, you're the one who did your criminology degree, right, in Belgium. I'm just a YouTuber who make up things to get views. I would like to be enlightened. Tell me. These youths are what's up on the camera, and the hundreds, maybe thousands more than Jamaican. Since modern day Jamaicans are doing something right, why are we not delivering the results? Why are people in countries like Benin, countries like Congo, countries like Malawi, Burkina Faso, people who have less, have been through so much more, why them not produce them youth? Ask yourself that question. What are they doing different from Jamaicans? They're less educated, poorer, less resources, no light, no water. But yet still they murder it lower than Uncle Samone. So what them know, what you wanna know. Modern day woke to this, we're enlightened, right? This is the best era Jamaica has ever seen. Right? We now have more money, more resources, more road, more everything. This should be the best of we. But look what we are produced. You heard me right, we are produced. The same way you claim you see in bold, and the same way we claim Shellyanne, and the same way you're gonna claim them either, because they are products of Jamaica. You can just claim as an offer, right, and claim the youth them are the good things. And say, oh, we produce, you see, and well, like, you produce them either too. These youths are product of Jamaica. They're not isolated. There's not like a one-off, or a couple, or a few. we produce them. Like how Honda produce the Accord. Mass production, the conveyor belt can't stop. Some want people tell me in the comment section, because as I say, I don't know. I'm just here to fight against artists and scammers. So tell me. I would like to be educated. Right, educate me. Bring me up to scratch. Modern day Jamaicans are so much more enlightened and so much better off, and we finally cracked off the race pit and do them things. So why we not produce the results? How youth in our country like Sierra Leone, we've been through hell and powderhouse, have thousands upon thousands of rifles left over from them civil conflict, and them did not take them up to go farm the Klansman and the stone crusher, but Jamaican youth who never had them in the first place have to go import them and bring them to us and buy them us and bring them to us. So go through any means to get them just to go fight war with man. Talk to me. Look at the results. Nobody cares about your feelings. We feel, look at the results. Results speak for themselves. Number one in the whole region, maybe the whole world. Something is wrong with our society and our culture, and people don't want to talk about it. People want to let our card use them more money. They use them, they have money, they won't do this. When the weapon them have in that man costs $400,000. The weapon them have in that man can buy a car put on the road. Talk to me. As I said, I don't know. So I try to look two views. How can people who, when you compare on paper, should be ripping themselves apart because, you know, them not have this and them not have that, and that is the story in Jamaica, because you say them not have nothing. What them people, their parenting and family structure and community and nation are do? Different from what we are do. Clearly we're doing something wrong. But Jamaica is the land of wood, water and delusion. A bunch of delusional people who've convinced themselves that they're so amazing the whole world, wish they could be Jamaica. And then they take the few exceptional cases like you see in Bolton and Shelley and Fraser, and then secede the whole world. Nobody know I'll be like you. Get over yourself. Jamaica is a highly acidic, destructive nation. Top murder charge every single year. Get over yourself. Let's call it what it is, because since your favorite politician now tell you, me tell you, because I don't want to vote. Jamaica is a massively underachieving nation, packed with overgrown pitney. Big people in a picnic body. Can't even settle basic disputes. Jamaica has devolved, keyword, devolved, into a nation. We're finding another Jamaican who you can trust is the exception, not the norm. Finding a Jamaican who is not highly acidic is the exception, not the norm. Finding a Jamaican who possess intangible qualities like integrity and honor is the exception, not the norm. Somebody had to tell you. Go ahead, hit the dislike button. Then run along and listen to your favorite woke activist who tell you, say, just because, but, right? So you can feel good about underachieving. So you can feel good about the fact that after all this time, since our quote-unquote independence, the majority of our accomplishments have been in either sports or music. Nobody talk about no economy, nobody talk about no education, nobody talk about nothing, nobody talk about industry, nobody talk about commerce, right? Nobody talk about manufacturing, nobody talk about none of that. And instead of talking about manufacturing 87s, 90s and 116, then of course now we have a conversation. And to show you how the culture back was, the people who have been excelled in fields outside of sports and music, right? People, you know, the intellectuals and the people them who not have the fame and the hype. Jamaicans don't want nothing to do with them. Nobody don't want to be like them. People are nerd. A Jamaican brains boy or girl can't get the same ratings like 87. Even if they invent the cure for the big C. I mean, can somebody explain to me why Jamaica can't come out of the top 5 highest murder rate in the whole world for the last 2 decades? Is it that we can't do it or we don't want to do it? Which one is it? Which one do you think it is? We can't do it or we don't want to do it? Here's a challenge for Jamaica. Go under 1,000 murders for your calendar year. Just do it 1 year. I could see. 1 year. And that's a challenge to the society. Not even to no Minister of National Security or no Commissioner of Police, because me already tell you about them already. Me already tell you it's a roller coaster this. Up, down, up, down. None of the control over nothing will happen. Nothing at all. Everybody just get for them turn to office, don't deliver the results, and then after them left, them turn expert. Not while them in the office and have the power, and afterwards, that's when them have all the answers. Afterwards. Jamaican leaders are at them best after them left the work. That's when you have to link them and ask them for the answers, but don't ask them while they're in the office though. But after all, it's said and done. Despite the video, everybody can see, and the little picnic, everybody can see, and people online are going to go on like, you're going to see even hardcore kerosenes who tell us that them only want 87 in them all. Even them, you're going to see pretend for one day, 36 hours maximum. Like say, they can't believe what them see, and them so hurt by what them see. But as them put on them phone, them draw the sheet over them and them 87 man who probably just come off our apps similar to that. But even them and the woke TV and everybody, you know what this is gonna come down to? You know what gonna happen? No matter what you see in the video, how bad the video look, you know what this is gonna be in Jamaica? 2 day story. Because so much things are going under the country that by the time Monday morning come around and Tuesday morning come around, there's been like 3 or 4 other incidents. But tap this and make you forget about the previous one. It's so hard to keep up. Even yesterday when I was getting the stories coming out of Brayton, coming out of Mobie, where you're about over yes, it's like, how people even keep up? Jamaicans can't even mourn. Jamaicans can't even stop and say, boy, this really, because by the time people start feel bad for that case, and they have to feel about the next case, and then it's just never ending. But when push comes to shove, we have to just face it. This is the Jamaica we deserve. This is the Jamaica we have built. It's not like say, the nation is undeserving. You cannot plant mango seed and expect apple to grow. Jamaican people plant the worst seeds, and then when them see the tree grow, people start holding them head and I say, how we get here, so we don't know how we get here, so we don't know. People don't want to change this. People say they want to see change, but they don't want to change. They want to keep doing the same thing over and over, and in those hopes that one day, Bruce Wayne or Clark Kent just turn police commissioner, turn minister of national security, and then that's it. Then we drop the 200 murders a year. That's what Jamaicans are hoping for. See, when you hear me say, I'm not giving up on Jamaica, I'm not talking about the so-called big people then. I'm talking about the next generation. That is why you hear me focus. When you see me do the Hodges video and the doggy video, and then in the J-Bad video, you hear me talking about, you hear me directly speaking to the youth. When me say, I'm not giving up on Jamaica, at them me talk, I'm not talking about the so-called adults then. Let's face it, for enough people in Jamaica, it's too far gone. I don't think they could become less acidic even if they tried. It's soaked in them brain, it's soaking in them DNA. Some can probably reform, but enough can't. Of course, Jamaica is still home to a lot of people who do wish the country well. Right? That are solid, productive people who, if given the chance, right, could turn the country around, but they might have a hell of a battle on them hand dealing with so much LIQ, dealing with so much acidic people. And we know these people feel outnumbered. Right? Remember my old video where I said acidic people were up by 40 points in the fourth quarter. I feel like we've made some gains, but them still up by about 32 points, fourth quarter. The game they're done. The game is not finished, but let's face it, acidity. The agents of death and destruction in Jamaica, the culture, we nurture and produce it. They're up by 32 points in the fourth quarter. The results alone show you that they're winning. You cannot top the murder charge for the entire region if these people are not winning. I'm say these people, I'm not just talking 87s or 90s, I'm talking about the culture and the society, the factory that breeds these people. Not just read them, right, but repair them, because them even come with warranty. 87s in Jamaica come with warranty. 90 and 116s come with warranty. There's a repair shop for them. If they ever get no kind of damage, here comes the mechanic, which is one of them agents, whether kerosene or them mother or whoever, ready for prop them up, right? Fix them parts and put them back on the road. Nurture him, alright, no worries, we'll soon get them back on the streets. That is our culture. We are talking about a culture, we. People tell you, say, you are no bad man, as a diss. In Jamaica, telling somebody, say, you are no 87 is a diss. You are no man at all, I might tell you, say, move right this after, you are no bad man. That's a diss in Jamaica. Imagine somebody telling you that you are not a criminal, and that person is telling you as a way of degrading you. Or if you degrade somebody by telling them you are not a criminal, we must see something wrong with Jamaican culture, Jamaican society. We must say that. Man, I go tell man, say, move from right this after, you never kill nobody yet. That's a diss. In Jamaica, that is a diss. Because if you are 87 and you have gone upon criminal ops and you have wet up people ends, then you get ratings. When in other societies, in other cultures, you would be a degenerate and nobody no want nothing to do with you, and a woman no want to reproduce with you, and nobody, and not even your own family want to near you. But in Jamaica, you are the man. You know, let me end this one right here, though. I probably shouldn't even be making videos like this because, you know, in order to make a video like this, you need to be qualified. You need to have done about 2 criminology courses. Right? One in New York and one in Canada. Then maybe, just maybe, you qualify to talk about them things. So because I never do the course, right, I leave them conversation alone and things are bigger than me. Anyway, Patreon squad, record for the video in about half an hour time. I'm going to break it down and show them why I encourage Jamaican citizens to take the necessary steps to protect themselves. Because if they want to come up against the 87, assuming him don't catch you off guard, right, and you know, walking in some kind of ambush, the odds are in your favor because a complete circus. Anyway, PIA, big up on yourself. Volta squad, I know you're circling. That's what you do. But in an ecosystem, even vultures have to eat. Bless.